Welcome again to the third part of my EDM build. Today's the day we will finally EDM our way through some parts. My trash EDM was built around the reaction of a power supply when current is drawn. Here's a short video of my old setup. So my first test setup here was again based around this lab power supply. It can be current regulated, meaning if you draw more than the amps you set, the voltage will drop. Analog input of the Arduino is connected to the power supply through a voltage divider to protect the pin. This allows us to detect the probe state from the machine with the Arduino. This setup then results in a slow but steady EDM process. But at just a few hertz, it's still quite slow compared to an industrial machine. That's because the limiting factor is the reaction time of the switched power supply. Nevertheless, I managed to try a few things. I drilled a hole through a nut with a copper wire. I tried the EDM scalpel against the sand coin, but that wasn't very effective since the scalpel steel isn't a very good fit for EDM. On the other hand, graphite is a very good fit for EDM probes. So I decided to build my own EDM graphite die. I cut a 1 cm graphite plate with my CNC and printed a holder for that. Then I tested it with a coin and it worked well, but due to the high surface area and low spark frequency, it took very long. The next thing I tried was the PCB. Yes, you heard right. EDMing a single-sided copper PCB is a thing, as you can see here. It actually worked. Well, I hadn't had really much of a circuit on that, but as you can see, should be possible to just mill a pattern in there and then practically stamp that onto a single layer PCB. I tried to create more sparks per second by switching the power supply over a solid state relay with about 500 Hz. This actually worked quite well until I added a big condensator. And the resulting currents killed the relay after a few minutes. So back to the drawing board. I needed a quicker response, so instead of measuring the reaction of the power supply, I could just read out the current directly. I got myself a few 2-ohm resistors. By measuring the voltage drop over them, I can calculate the current with the Arduino. This actually worked and I managed to increase the spark frequency by quite a bit. Problem now was, there are 4 ohms of resistance in my probe circuit, which resulted in slow material removal rates due to the current limitation the resistors brought with them. I need a shunt. So I got myself a shunt. The shunt has a 30 ampere range. if 30 ampere flows through this shunt, it will create a voltage of 75 millivolts. Oh, 75 millivolts? Yes. It's actually that low. That could become a problem. Maybe. The ADC of the Arduino won't like that. But I can just use one of the LM386 I have lying around here to amplify the 75 millivolts to 5 volts. Great idea, but A, the LM386 doesn't have the gain you need, and B, it's coupled for AC signals. Okay, so now I need an instrumental amp like a LM666? Yeah, or an ENA260? But the ENA260 isn't a very good idea when you want to add a 40 kHz to the probe later, since the frequency response degrades after 100 Hz. So an instrumental amp it is, I guess. And where we are at it, also add a 24-bit ADC. I'm happy for that measuring noise. Maybe a 24-bit ADC isn't the best idea. But why add 40 kHz anyway? Because right now the spark frequency is limited by the mass lag of the motors, meaning I form my pulses by moving up and down. NEMA 17 motors can be vibrated, but that's mechanically stressful and not as quick as a solid-state pulse generation. But how does one generate a powerful high-frequency pulsed voltage source? Well, you could buy an expensive one, or experiment a bit. I will try to use a mono audio amplifier for that purpose. On the other hand, I have a backup plan that is just using a motor PVM controller that could also work quite well. We will see what if from this will work. The bonus side could be if the audio amp works, then I can maybe play music on my EDM machine. But we will see about that. As always, all the code and links and everything you need for this you will find in the description and on the GitHub page of the project. Next time we will get a little more into detail with the pulse power supply and see if we can get this to work. And also installing an acrylic basin so we can see the object getting cut under the oil, since the new enclosure will be out of plexiglass. So that was it for today, and I guess I see you next time. Ever found yourself in a position where you had to move around some oil? What pump type would you need for this? A. A membrane pump, B. A peristaltic pump, or C. A gear pump? We have a winner, it's C. The gear pump. A peristaltic pump will work too, but it's only needed if you have to fine dose your volume flow, also it's very slow. A membrane pump will not work at all, since its valves aren't made for a fluid this viscous.